Russian outlet Kommersant reported that the military prosecutor's office recovered the money from an enterprise that repaired 4 nuclear submarines of the Russian Northern Fleet without the necessary special licenses. The head of the company received a sentence for illegal entrepreneurship in the field of state defense orders. It's noteworthy that the customer, which in this case is the Russian Military of Defense, had no complaints about the quality of the work. This is an interesting development, as nuclear-powered submarines are sensitive assets, and a fault in them could result in a catastrophe in the future. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes potential hazardous repair of Russian nuclear submarines. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. On February 18, 2014, between the Ministry of Defense and the company CS Zvezdochka, a state contract was signed for serial maintenance and repair of ships and vessels of the Northern Fleet for the period of 2014 to 2016. As co-executor of the contracts, CS Zvezdochka brought in SPTB Zvezdochka. In 2014 to 2015, SPTB Zvezdochka performed work at the electric compression stations of the Panther nuclear submarine worth 7.4 million rubles, the Volk nuclear submarine, 2.5 million rubles, the Voronezh nuclear submarine, 340,000 rubles, the Gepard nuclear submarine, 2 million rubles, and so on, for which the general contractor transferred to the company a total of 14.4 million rubles. The lawsuit of the military prosecutor's office against SPTB Zvezdochka and its former leader, Konstantin Kriukin, were granted by the Polar District Court of the Murmansk region located in the city of Gadzhevo. As the investigation authorities and then court established, Kriukin headed SPTB Zvezdochka from January 2013 to January 2016. SPTB Zvezdochka's specialists worked in places of permanent deployment of nuclear submarines in the cities of Gadzhevo and Zazersk. When it turned out that the work was carried out without a license, Konstantin Kriukin was charged with committing a crime under subsection B of Part 2 of Article 171 of the Criminal Code. Illegal business associated with the extraction of income in a particularly large amount. He was sentenced to 1.5 years in prison. However, given that the entrepreneur was previously convicted under Part 1 of Article 201 of the Criminal Code for abuse of power, also committed in the repair of vessels of the Northern Fleet, the term was increased to 2.5 years of settlement. Turning to the court, the military prosecutor's office indicated that Kriukin had deliberately made a deal with a goal of obviously contrary to the foundations of law and order and morality, which also affected the interests of the country's defense and security. The supervision demanded that the transaction be recognized as null and void, and the income from it should be turned into the income of the treasury of the Russian Federation. The representative of the convict Kriukin did not agree with the prosecutor's lawsuit, believing that the stated claims were unfounded. According to him, there are no grounds for satisfying the claim of the prosecutor's office, since all of the work was carried out efficiently and on time. The court decided that SPTB Zvezdochka had performed works whose necessary quality was not and could not be adequately insured due to the company's lack of a license to repair armaments and military equipment in the corresponding class. Noting that Kriukin's dishonesty and wrongfulness of actions was established by a verdict that entered into force, and the transaction was void, the court collected 14,407,930 rubles from the former general director of SPTB, Zvyazdochka, and the enterprise itself, as well as estate duty. Out of the four submarines, three, Panther, Volk, and Gepard, are of Akula class. The Akula class, Soviet designation, Project 971, Shuka B, are a series of nuclear-powered attack submarines, SSNs, first deployed by the Soviet Navy in 1986. There are four subclasses, though Russians call all of the submarines Shuka B regardless of modifications. The Akula class was designed primarily to hunt and kill enemy submarines, as well as surface combatants. For this, the class has four 533mm torpedo tubes with 28 torpedoes, and four 650mm torpedo tubes with 12 torpedoes. It has a secondary role of surface attack. For this, caliber land attack cruise missiles are present. The fourth one, Vronezh, is an Oscar I class submarine. The Oscar class, Soviet designations Project 949 Granite and Project 949A Ante, NATO reporting names Oscar 1 and Oscar 2 respectively, are a series of nuclear-powered cruise missile submarines designed in the Soviet Union for the Soviet Navy. The class is mainly designed for land attack, and the submarines of this class are one of the largest in the world. The nuclear-powered Oscar-class submarine Kursk sank in an accident on the 12th of August in the year 2000 in the Barents Sea, during the first major Russian naval exercise in more than 10 years, and all 118 personnel on board were killed. Nearby ships felt the initial explosion and a second, much larger explosion. Yet the Russian Navy did not realize that an accident had occurred and did not initiate a search for the sub for more than 6 hours. By the time the Navy declared an emergency, 11 hours later, the crew had all died, although no observers knew that. Over 4 days, the Russian Navy repeatedly failed in its attempts to attach four different diving bells and submersibles to the escape hatch of the submarine. President Vladimir Putin initially continued his vacation at a seaside resort and authorized the Russian Navy to accept British and Norwegian offers of assistance only after 5 days had passed since the accident. 7 days after the sinking, Norwegian divers finally opened a hatch to the escape trunk in the ship's flooded ninth compartment, but found no survivors. Most of the wreck was raised and analyzed. The official investigation concluded that as the crew of Kursk was preparing to load a dummy 6576 kit torpedo, a faulty weld in its casing leaked high-test peroxide, HTP, causing the torpedo's kerosene fuel to explode. The torpedo manufacturer challenged this hypothesis, insisting that its design would prevent the kind of event described. Vice Admiral Valery Ryazantsev drew attention to systemic faults in the Russian Navy, such as the risky use of highly volatile HTP torpedoes known to have exploded and caused the sinking of HMS Sidon. Ryazantsev accused the Russian Navy of failing to properly train the crew, who did not appear to have properly closed the internal tube hatch cover. Eventually, the commission concluded that poor oversight, budget cuts, and incomplete maintenance inspections contributed to the explosion. This remains one of the starkest reminders of how things can go wrong with even small oversights. Admiral Vladimir Korolev, the commander-in-chief of the Russian Navy, had said his submarine crews spent more than 3,000 days underwater in 2016 alone. He added Russian subs are patrolling the seas at levels last seen during the Cold War. Even in the last year, the Russian Air Force, as well as the Russian Navy, has been carrying out aggressive maneuvers. But incidents, small and big, have happened, which indicates everything is not well. On the 30th of October 2018, Admiral Kuznetsov suffered a major mishap while undergoing overhaul work at a dockyard in Rozlyakovo near Murmansk. The aircraft carrier nearly sank. To know more on that, check the video on the above card. In December of last year, Russian officials have stated that Russia's most advanced fighter jet, Sukhoi Su-57, has crashed during a training flight. It's clear that Russia is overstretching its military in an attempt to confront the West, but it may do well to take a step back and review the operational and quality assurance process.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.